committee that's watching the local goal and saying, it's going to die. The software will fail and we can't fix it. It won't be down for a week, it'll be down for a much longer period of time. But we can't get rid of it. And if you want me to tell you which, why we can't, people won't focus on it. The best answer we get, it's working this week, it's okay. It works for me.
That's a private conversation he and I just had about the breach, was the idea that an oil change is always easier than an engine rebuild. But I know you already know that. Like, that's kind of a useless thing for me to say here.
But no, it's dead after. I will drag you with me to the board and tell them that.
Well, they probably don't need me to tell them that. I'm sure they know that. Like, we just
ask for it. They really do.
11-4.
Yes, where I'm going. I was talking about the problem we have with people having different ideas. That's the one. It's not a different idea, it's just that we can't get moving. Okay, how many of you think you ought to know what the league is doing with your money?
50 minutes.
Oh, God. How many of you think you ought to know how the person you elect as director votes? Or you don't want to know, you don't have to go. All right, so do I. So does the league. That's not a universal opinion of the board. We operate under Robert's Rules of Order, and if a vote comes up on any motion, doesn't matter what it is. Anyone in the board can ask for a roll call vote. That means everyone's vote gets counted by name. Okay. Anyone want to tell me how long it takes to move a roll call vote in that room? 33 seconds. We've timed it. Okay. My view is, if you're crazy enough to put me in that room, I owe you the responsibility of telling you what we are doing and what I did, even if it's done. You are also entitled to know how everyone else did. That's not a universal thought. This came up really hot in this last board meeting. I missed that board meeting. Last summer, the board passed a motion. They said, okay, whoa. If you want to have a roll call vote, you have to get five others in the room to agree. That's not what those were. They imposed a restriction on top of it that said you got to get five people to agree with you to call a roll call vote.
No.
Why? Because someone said this in the room. Well, we keep roll call votes. The members don't know how we're voting. That's a problem. That was fought, we lost it, and came back to this in this board meeting. They've now enhanced that restriction. Now, you can't even use five to get a vote on anything except government's motions. And if any of you can tell me what a government's motion is, I'll buy you a beer. It's wide open, we don't know. He mentioned 11-4. Hang on, wait, I don't want you to talk about it. There is if you read the stuff we put out for the last board meeting, Mike Riesbeck, who used to be a first vice president, and identified a group of the board as a shadow board, 11 of the 15. They work as a unit. There's nothing wrong with having an operating unit, nothing wrong with having a majority. That is a good thing. This group, back to the last board meeting, was meeting privately with the CEO, we're told, and excluded the rest of the board and came up with motions that are outrageous for company men. That's where the number comes from. It's 11-4 vote. If you go back to the July meeting, which ended the QST as part of your membership, 11-4 vote. Go back and look at the minutes that are published. Look at how many of those votes are 12-3, 11-4. Who are the four? Atlantic Division, Bob Familio. Southwest Division, Dick Norton. Occasionally, Mickey Baker out of Southeast Division, Florida, that area, and the West Gulf. If you go back to 2016 and 2017, there was a huge fight over the adoption of what was referred to as a gag order. It prohibited COI, it prohibited any director from telling any of his members how any other director voted. He couldn't even tell you how he voted without permission. Yeah. That turned into a really hot fight at the board because it's supposed to all have been done secret. When the word got out to the members, everyone's upset. It came back up into another fight, which eventually we got rid of it. But who voted against that? The Atlantic Division, Southwest Division, Southeast Division, and West Division. The divisions who fought to keep the members aware of what the board was doing are the same ones now. On this motion to, but you were going to make a comment.
I was going to give an insight to the way the board, since you brought this up. So when this discussion came up, when Kristen put the discussion out about the roll call vote.
Kristen McIntyre is the director, is first vice president.
Okay. You would think, do I really need this?
Yes. Walk this way.
You would think that we would have a detailed discussion about the pros and cons of this. But immediately somebody says, well, have we looked at electronic voting? And then we got into a discussion about, well, do we want red and green lights? Do we want purple buttons? Do we want to look at this study? Do we want to go look at that application? Do we want to do a subgroup? And they basically just said anything they could to talk about except talk about the purpose of the bill. Okay, they deliberately ran it off, and we sat there, we had a 20-minute discussion about hand-raising versus electronic voting versus what we should do and how we should do it and how long it would take. And then at the end, everybody got exhausted, and they sat there and said, oh, what the hell, pass the bill and stuff. And that's how that works on a lot of board meetings and stuff. People don't really want to get into it. They will sit there and they will find a tangent, they'll find something else to talk about to reflect it. That's what one you kind of bring up.
From the
Here,
The point is the motion passed.
Yes.
Which makes it difficult now for you to know what the board is doing. Is everything the board does bad? No, it's not. Well, if the league goes away, we're gonna have issues. But you need to know, you're entitled to know what the board is doing with your money. Even if only 48% operating, it's still your money, particularly since we reached the dues. So that is not a good thing. That is the shadow board that's 11-4 votes this time. I don't know if we can get it reversed. You might expect that we're going to keep doing what we have been doing. We call for roll call one every time anyway. Sometimes we get it, sometimes we don't. There are proposals to modify IT that came up this time. To create IT committees to study everything we do. We don't know what that really does. It's people look at the minutes, look at it, we don't know what that motion really means. I just know that sounds silly, but we don't. But let me go back and make a point about the roll call vote. We're a Connecticut corporation. Everyone who's elected is elected under Connecticut law. Under Connecticut law, every director has a responsibility, what's called fiduciary duty, to the organization and to the members. In this discussion, you have directors stand up and go, it's none of their damn business.